Chris Dyer. I like to travel the world doing art, having fun, and meeting interesting people. I hope you enjoyed this art adventure. Hungary, where I've been invited to live paint at Ozora Festival. But first, I am starting in this beautiful city of Budapest. So, hope you enjoy. What are you doing to that poor fish, kid? Fishes are your friends.
City compared to most European capitals. It's quite cozy, walkable, and rather cheap, and still very modern. You find it all which you can use and need. People are maybe not the most friendly in this town, so don't get too surprised when you scroll around yourself. English is not their strength, so they might just run away when you want to know something. They just turn around and pretend they never heard you.
Nice.
But you will meet tons of tourists at this time, so English is not that hard at all. They will just not know how to help you.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, I'm gonna make you famous, man. I just think it's really cool that the coins they got here, because they don't use euro.
Yeah, that's our King Matthias. This guy, he is some almost king guy. He built the chain bridge and the tunnels according to his
plans. So there's this funicular going up the mountain to this castle, but apparently you gotta wait a whole hour to get up there. So I'm just gonna walk it. It's quicker, nicer, good exercise, the right ones. Walking is healthy. Lineups are unhealthy. Enjoying the sun is nice. Ooh, sticker spot. Yeah. Sticker spot. Hell yeah. And now we've arrived to this castle area. Azon a csapon hagyom, nagyon hagyom, mind ide kiterítem, és számolom mindazt, ami volt. See, walking, you get to see sights of this old guy. Vodka? He's so cute!
Everywhere.
All right, that whole castle area was super fun, interesting, good vibes. And now I'm gonna cross this beautiful bridge to get to the other side and take a boat and take a little boat ride. Check out more nice views of beautiful Budapest. Alright, we're taking a boat trip. Should be fun. Fuck yeah. It's really rainy, but I'm sure I'll get better. So now I'll be dry for me to enjoy a nice cheesy touristy day. Alright, new day here in Budapest.
Ez is Fürdik.
Fürdik?
Fürdik, ez a úszlik.
It's Balland. Taking a taxi downtown. Gonna do a spa today. Thermal waters. Should be great. So I'm at the Hotel Gellert right now, where I'm told they have some of the best thermal waters. And Eray told me I had to do a thermal water while I'm here in Budapest. So I'll enjoy that.
What's going on?
Well, I feel very relaxed now after steam bath and all those hot pools. It was just really nice. I enjoyed it. So now I'm just gonna walk around and explore a little bit more. Wow. Finally found a skate park. So I'm continuing to walk and I'm crossing the bridge going from the Pest to the Buddha side, and it winds and breaks into this third option where I can go to Margarita Island, which is this extra little nature island that I'm gonna go check that out. This is Margarita Island. Looks a lot like Montreal now. Nice ruins. I've been waiting to give this to you. Now on, I will make sure you know it's true. Cause I won't hesitate for it to be too late. So I must
concentrate on the floor, open the thingy. You need it to open there something. And throw. Ha! Standing! Standing ovation!
So I just arrived to the premises of Ozora. It's big and nice in nature, and there's lots of cool permanent installations, which is very nice, sustainable thing to have. Everybody's working really hard building beautiful things for people to enjoy once the crowds arrive. I myself will start painting a mural soon. That's my role here. So we all do little pretty things for the enjoyment of nice people who come to have a good time with us. Tell me a little bit about Ozora, why you think it's special?
Because it's a life-changing experience, like all transformational festivals, and it's one of the rare kinds in Europe. We do some probably a little bit more than that. Once you enter, you don't come out the same way. That's kind of it. Hopefully more open. That's what we try to achieve, a more open-minded crowd.
The fact that this place here has been here for many years and you're getting to see and join part of that evolution and it stays is beautiful, and it's like that utopian dream of like a community and something that you can build and it will grow and it will stay and get stronger. So I feel like it's a really beautiful thing they have here and they're really lucky to have it. You know, it's a great place for people to come and be inspired. I think a lot of people come to the festivals for music and the art is kind of an afterthought, which, you know, I can understand, but it's something for people to ground and be inspired and change the way they think and the way that they look at the world. And that's kind of what we're doing with this specific art, is we're changing the way people see wood, so maybe now they appreciate it more, maybe they appreciate the world around them a little more. There's beauty everywhere. It might be hiding right underneath the surface.
I've been out here at the Ozora Festival grounds for a month, working pretty much from sun up to sundown with a team of 4 to 6 people. And we've also been building with all the wood and materials that we could find on the land. This project here is the Cat Chapel, and the intention was to create a space, really, it's like a guardian, giving people an opportunity to maybe look inward, just like the cat is a solitary creature. And so I really liked working with that energy and giving an opportunity for me and my tribe to do something unique, which is create an art piece that is both an exterior art piece and an interior art piece. On the inside, we have Brad Radwood and his crew creating an amazing interior, all surround stained paint job on the plywood. While I got to do a sculptural wood art piece on the outside.
It's the first time we've done something on that type of scale, and it's where we all want to be going. It's more interactive, more installation, and it's something that we could never do by ourselves. So we're giving into that collaboration spirit and making things that we never thought would be possible before, and now they are. So it's a scary but fun, and like definitely the way we want to all be going.
Yeah. the wall is freaking huge. It's like the biggest wall I ever painted. Oh, it reminds me of the fact that we are all interconnected with each other. It's really the blueprint of the universe. I think for me it's like some kind of meditation. Not always when I'm painting the wall in circumstances like this, but...
Shit, the rain's changing directions now. Now that my mural's done, I've just been spending the 8 days at Ozora Festival, which is a long period of time, mostly at the gallery painting my canvas and hanging out with artist friends, having nice conversations, maybe checking a little bit out, dance floor or two, not too much, just like to keep it chill. But yeah, you know, it's been a good time. I like it here, everybody's really friendly. Psytrance is driving me and all my artist friends kind of crazy. It's like a non-stop boom, boom, boom that really debilitates you. But yeah, we keep on trucking forward, finding performances with instruments if possible, and making some nice art. So yeah, grateful to be here.
Thank you. I love painting. Why do I love a woman in my life? It's the same question, because to love a woman, to love a painting, sounds the same meaning for me, because to paint is like to alive, and to love a woman is just to alive also. As a complement of our lives as an artist, I think it's very important to have such cosmic vibration, because as a woman, vibration also in painting is just universal aesthetic vibration in our blood, in our brain, in our pineal gland, in our eyes, in our breathing, in our cells, in our food. Vibration is right there, vibration of feeding us from the cosmic natural. So, pain is like necessity. Mm-hmm. Like to love is a necessity for a human being to be conscious of their existence, conscious to be partner in a group, to be partner of the universe, you know?
Well, I've been in the town of Badatomaldi for a couple of days now, but all I've done is paint, so today I'm exploring a little bit. Anderson has moved on my own, so I'm just gonna like check out this town a little bit, maybe take a boat trip, and yeah, enjoy this beautiful town. Beautiful. Thanks for shaking it, baby.
Cocked, locked, and ready to rock, ready to rock. Shut me up, rough, tough, and hard to bluff, hard to bluff, hard to bluff, hard to bluff. You can't dumb me down. I got no need for coke and speed, coke and speed, coke and speed, coke and speed.
All right, so the boat now has stopped in this little town. I don't know what I'm gonna do other than eat a little bit and just lay on the beach, maybe swim a little. Just enjoy it till the boat ride gets me back home. Kinda miss painting by now, but yeah, just enjoying some nature and good times out here in Hungarian nature.
I'm wireless, I'm an alpha male on beta blockers. Interactive, I'm hyperactive, from time to time I'm radioactive. I take it slow, I go with the flow, I ride with the tide, I get line in my stride. I don't snooze, so I don't lose. I keep the pedal to the metal and the rubber on the road. I've been pre-washed, pre-cooked, pre-heated, pre-screened, pre-approved, pre-packaged, pre-washed, pre-cooked, pre-heated, pre-screened, pre-approved, pre-packaged, pre-screened, and... I'm hanging in, there ain't no doubt, and I'm hanging tough, over and out.
All right, so I made it back to Budapest, and before I leave tomorrow, I'm gonna try to drop a fish bomb, you know? I try to always drop one of these fishes around the world, so hopefully I can still do this before I leave this country. Till then, eating my falafel pita. Chris got a spot for me.
You make it more of a central location.
Yeah.
You get more.
Nice. Thanks for finding me a spot, man. The vulture's being attacked by a bunch of moths. Oh my god, there's so many moths. So we've arrived at this wall that we're told that it's not illegal to paint that in order to do my fish bomb. But the wall is like falling to pieces, like the paint is crumbling down. So Fred here is helping me to scrape it. And I'm gonna also got a stick to paint off and get a little bit smoother of the fish bomb. As long as I don't get in trouble before leaving Hungary, I think I'm all good. Eventually, some police actually arrived and they stopped me from continuing doing the mural. They said it actually was illegal, which I didn't know. And then I just explained to them I just wanted to do something beautiful in that random wall, that I was just a Canadian artist coming through, and they understood and they actually allowed me to finish. They gave me half an hour more and I had to rush through it, but I think I did a good job in the end and I was happy. Julia next episode. I still don't know what the next location will be, but it always promised to be a good time. So I'll see you then.
Peace.
This episode, please click like and also subscribe so you can catch my future episodes. Have a good one.
Peace.